Advisor for Private Sector Development at GIZ in India, specialized on the promotion of micro, small and medium enterprises and on innovation promotion. Since 2010, she has been heading a project component for bilateral technical cooperation between India and Germany on MSME financing and development with the Small Industries Development Bank of India, SIDBI, as an implementation partner. Currently, she is leading a new initiative within GIZ on responsible enterprise finance, aiming to strengthen the integration of environmental, social, and governance concerns in lending and investment decision making for financial institutions. She is an economics and social sciences graduate from London School of Economics and Political Science, UK, and the University of Bayern, Germany. Stephanie, over to you.
Distinguished Minister, City Venture Capital, a warm welcome also from GIZ side, and I should send the greetings also from the German Embassy, who unfortunately could not make it here today. We are very happy that this event is happening today here in Patna, and we are very excited that so many innovative businesses are also here today in the room, and we will hear more about the business models later on during the day. It is important for us that gatherings and events like this are happening and bringing together different actors from the government, from the private sector, innovative entrepreneurs, but also support institutions and incubators. We want to discuss here today also how these challenges that have been mentioned also by the minister and by others previously can be addressed by innovations by the private sector and by small businesses. We know that small businesses are increasingly contributing to addressing challenges in energy, water, education, health, and they challenge the conventional thinking about doing business. But these innovators need also an enabling environment, and this is what we would like to discuss here today in some of the sessions. I'm not sure if you know who GIZ is, German International Corporation. We are working on behalf of the German government. We work with partners such as SIDBI, but also different ministries on national level, Ministry of MSME and others, to build capacities for sustainable development. We are globally working in 130 countries and work on issues such as energy, healthcare, social protection, sustainable economic development. We are launching now a new program which aims to strengthen the ecosystem for small innovators and social businesses, and this is why we are here today. I want to start with a little anecdote of a German enterprise to also illustrate what motivates us to be in that sector and also to illustrate what our vision for the sector is. So I want to tell you the story of these three young fellows which started an enterprise in the 70s called Husatronic. So these young engineer graduates had a good idea. They wanted to contribute to develop new energy solutions. They wanted to prove that they can do more than just protesting against nuclear energy, which at that time was a big thing. There were a lot of protests against nuclear energy. So they started to develop technology and to challenge conventional energy sourcing, and they started to develop the first photovoltaic energy devices, basically doing this in their living room. This was the beginning of the solar industry in Germany, and we know that today solar industry is quite big. So this business made it in the 90s to be registered on the stock market, and is until last year they have been one of the biggest solar companies in Germany, with around 900 employees worldwide. What this story shows us is that social businesses need patience. Yeah? It took them 30 years to be actually listed at the stock market, and they started with an idea. So we see that the process from exploration and idea to actually making an innovation viable on the market takes some time. So what this also shows us that there need to be actors who have patience and trust. And we also see that these businesses need support institutions that help them grow, so support and incubation support services. And we see, Sorry, that's the thing about technique. We see that finance is only one part of the equation. Finance is an important aspect in the equation, but it's only one aspect. So coming to India, we know the complex challenges are big. We know access is a problem in social services, environmental problems are huge. I don't need to mention the challenges again. But we see, and we have heard it already, there are businesses in the room that want to make a change. So there are increasingly businesses that want to be change makers and that contribute with innovative solutions to addressing some of the challenges. The government has already some of the initiatives like National Innovation Council and wants to promote innovation, but we see that a lot is actually happening on the ground with businesses that want to create a change. And we have some of the businesses in the room today. We also see that we need to work on creating an enabling environment for these businesses. The businesses are active in an environment which creates a lot of, or which is full of risks. Small businesses are high risk businesses, we know this, and we need to create an enabling environment for these businesses to actually grow. So what we need to think about is also how we can create de-risking support for the investments. How can we think of financial innovations that that de-risk these investments? A little has been done so far to think about how financial innovations, different blended capital, can maybe be used to de-risk the investments. We also need to think about how to create markets. We know that the businesses are operating in very in areas where there are big market failures, and support institutions can actually help to create the market and to foster market development. So this is what we would like to discuss today with the actors that are in the room. We want to talk about incubation, how can we strengthen the incubation support, what can be ways of de-risking the investments, what can be ways to create markets and to actually create this enabling environment for social businesses. So this is what motivated us as GIZ to participate and to support the Sankalp Forum. And we see this really as a beginning in a long process, as has been mentioned before. This is the first milestone of more engagement in this sector. So we would like to welcome you again from GIZ side and wish you a very fruitful event today.